to your name, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for joining us live here on Facebook.
That's right.
We hope this program will be a blessing to you this morning.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
We're going to be talking about give thanks. But before we do that, we're going to go ahead and just worship the Lord for a few moments to Jesus Culture.
Yes.
As people are coming on, go ahead and invite your friends, your family, while we're worshiping the Lord. Good morning, Brother David.
Amen.
And let's just lift up the name of the Lord this morning.
Yes, amen. Thank you, Lord. Have your way, Father. Hallelujah. We give you glory today, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Praise your name, Father God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God bless you, Brother David.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He's so faithful, isn't he, Melissa?
I was thinking the same thing.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
The Lord will reward you for that, being faithful.
He will. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We bless your name today, Father. Hallelujah. We bless your name, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Mm-hmm. Yes, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. He's reaching out to us, yes. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. She's running for life. Hallelujah. What an awesome thought that his life is flowing through our veins.
That's
isn't
right.
that something?
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Thank
yes.
you, Lord. Yes, he's the God of miracles. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. We believe in you, God. Yes. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yes, he is the God of miracles. Praise your holy name, Jesus. Go ahead and share the program this morning with your friends. Hallelujah. Because we feel like we really have a good message this morning. I'm giving thanks. Hallelujah. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. There's prophets for today. God bless you this morning,
right.
sister. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
That's right. You are the same.
Yes, he is the same. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Yes, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you, Faye. We love you. So glad to see you this morning. You and your family are in our prayers. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Yes, hallelujah. God bless you, Teresa. We're glad to have you this morning. Hallelujah.
Thank
from the beautiful
you.
State of North Carolina. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Yes, yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, we believe in you this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We believe in you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're stretching our faith.
That's right. We are.
We're stretching our faith. Hallelujah.
Yeah, that's right. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. That was a good message last night. I thought it was very good. And we want to thank everyone for praying for Apostle. He's feeling much better today. Amen.
That's right.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. He was up and doing when we got up, wasn't he? Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Can't keep a good man down, can you?
No,
thank
you can't.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. But we're thankful for your prayers.
Yes.
for all your prayers for everyone. Hallelujah. Right. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Yes, thank you for your prayers.
I say this many times on this program and also, you know, in the church. We all need one another, Melissa. Mm-hmm. We do. We need our brothers and sisters. That's we right. really do. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Because we're fighting a war.
Mm-hmm. And we can't do it alone.
No.
That's right. We need the body of Christ. No. That's true.
No man has gone alone to war.
Yes, thank you, Father.
Besides
thank
David.
You, Father. Again, go ahead and share the program with your friends where they can hear.
That's right.
What the Lord is saying this morning, what He's given us to say
mm-hmm.
about being thankful.
That's right.
And you know, God is so good. God is so good.
That's right.
He is.
Thank you for joining us live here on Facebook. Just so you know, I know most of you probably know. Mm-hmm. How to follow us, but some might not, especially on YouTube or Twitter. You can follow us live every Thursday morning at 11 a.m. Mm-hmm. Mountain Time.
Mm-hmm.
Also on Sunday, 11 a.m. Mountain Time, and Wednesday evening, 7 p.m. Mountain Time. On Twitter under Soaring Eagle M1. Also on Facebook under Soaring Eagle Ministries International. Also on Facebook under Linda McClam Chance, and also on YouTube later on, we do post it, excuse me, under Soaring Eagle Ministries International. Excuse me. This morning, we're going to talk about give thanks. And we're coming from 1 Thessalonians 5 and 18.
Yes,
it says,
amen.
In everything, give thanks.
Everything.
Everything.
Wow.
No matter what. It is give thanks.
That leaves nothing out.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you're in jail, give thanks. You know?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
If you're in the hospital, give thanks. If you're on the job that you hate, give thanks.
Yes, yes.
You know, you're sick in the bed at home, give thanks.
Amen.
You know, wherever you are, give thanks to the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
For this is the will of God in Christ
yes,
Jesus concerning
yes, yes.
you. You know, we're at that time of the year where people are talk about being thankful because Thanksgiving season is upon us. Right now, we're planning our Thanksgiving meals and we're getting ready for the holidays. Some might say there's nothing really new about giving thanks to God, but yet there is. There is. Because each day that we wake up is a new day to be thankful for.
That's right.
No matter how we may or may not feel, we are still alive, and that alone is something to be thankful for.
Yes, amen. Thank you, Lord. You know, Melissa, God is so good.
Uh-huh.
God is so good.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank
you know,
Jesus.
The Word tells us, the Lord tells us not to grumble.
No.
And complain,
That's
you know,
right.
about what's going on in our lives
mm-hmm.
this morning, you know. You know, and we need to really praise God. And you know, I was thinking about as you were saying that, I was sort of looking at Psalms 145, and I wanted to just go ahead and read that, Melissa,
okay.
before I go ahead. And this is, of course, David.
Mm-hmm.
And David says, I will exalt you, my God, the King.
Mm-hmm.
I will praise your name forever
mm-hmm.
and ever. Every day I will praise you and extol your name. Listen, this is powerful here. And David is a good example for us. You know, he was
yes,
a mighty warrior, but he was also a mighty worshiper.
Mm-hmm.
So he says, every day I will praise you and extol your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise.
Mm-hmm.
His greatness no one can fathom. One generation will commend your works to another. They would tell of your mighty acts.
Mm-hmm.
They would speak of the glorious splendor of your majesty, and I will meditate on your wonderful works. They would tell of the power of your awesome works,
mm-hmm.
and I will proclaim your great deeds. They will celebrate your abundant goodness and joyfully sing of your righteousness. And then verse 8 says this, the Lord is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and rich in love. So we just want to say this morning, as we get started, that God is worthy to be praised,
that's
Melissa.
Right, that's right.
He's worthy to be praised. And you know, I was thinking about too what you had said, Melissa, especially now when we're still in the middle of a pandemic. Mm-hmm. I don't know about where you're from, but here in Arizona, we're still it's really running rampant again here in Arizona. It slowed down for a while, but it's back up again. And so we're still in the middle of a pandemic, mm-hmm. and people are dying, you know, not just from COVID, but from all sorts of illness.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
that's right.
Hallelujah. That's right, Brother David. We need to remember. Can you read that, Melissa, what he's saying
He
there?
Says we need to remember that we are not fighting against flesh and blood,
mm-hmm.
but against the rulers in the spirit realm.
That is
that's
so
right.
true.
Yeah.
That is so true. And so, you know, not only are we in the middle of a pandemic, but people are dying from COVID and
mm-hmm.
also from all sorts of illness.
Right.
Some people have died from going to concerts. You know, we just heard about that just recently,
mm-hmm.
Melissa. I think there was 10 or 11 so far that have died, I'm not sure. And then we've seen people die in the parks and in the schools. We've seen that in the
mm-hmm.
malls.
Mm-hmm.
Some have even gone as far as taking their own lives.
Wow.
And I heard a statistic just lately about how because of COVID, the rate of suicide has gone way up.
Mm.
You know, people feel like they have no hope and they're giving up and committing suicide.
Oh,
and this is a tragic, it's just tragic to hear this,
right.
that people are actually taking their lives because they see no way out of their troubles or they have nothing to live for. And I want to say to you this morning, if you're feeling down and maybe you're depressed or going through something, there is a reason to be thankful.
That's right.
There is a reason to be hopeful, and that's the Lord Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And God knows everything.
That's
Amen.
Right.
So when you get the urge to grumble and complain about everything or anything, remember all that you have and all that the Lord has done for you. You know, when I'm going through something, I always think back about what God's done in the past.
That's right.
And that builds our faith.
That's
we were
right.
talking about stretching our faith last night. And of course, you know, you can't really get into all of it on a short program. But that's one of the ways that we can stretch our faith
mm-hmm.
is when we see what God's done in the past. We
that's
know
right.
that He will be faithful now and
that's
in
right.
the future, no matter what we need or what our family needs or what our church needs or what our brothers and sisters need. God
mm-hmm.
is faithful. So He wants us to have our faith and trust in Him. And it says in Philippians 2:14-15, do everything without grumbling or arguing, so that you
mm-hmm.
may become blameless and pure. See, God is purifying the church.
That's right.
He's speaking to the church. That's one of the things that I believe that God is doing right now. He's
That's
getting
right.
the church prepared to bring in the end time harvest, the greater works people.
That's right.
And so He's purifying us. Amen. He's taking care of all those things that have caused us to maybe give up and quit, or I don't know the word I'm looking for, or procrastinate, but
mm-hmm.
God is taking care of all those things. He's purifying us. He wants us to be blameless and pure.
That's right.
Children of God without fault. And I like this, Melissa. It says, without fault in a warped and crooked generation.
Mm-hmm.
We live in a very warped and crooked generation. All one
right.
has to do is look around
mm-hmm.
and see what's happening, you know, in the world. It's unbelievable, but God is still God.
That's right.
It goes on to say, then you will shine among them like stars in the sky.
Mm-hmm.
See, no matter what's going on in the world, how bad it looks, how much sin we see, and it's everywhere, God
That's
wants
right.
us to shine like the stars in the sky. You know, we are His people.
That's right.
You know, God has chosen us. We're God's chosen ones.
That's right.
And, you know, we want to make sure that we shine for the Lord. One of the things that the Lord spoke to me in 2020 at our New Year's service, and I've said this before, but I'm going to say it again. The Lord said that great darkness would cover the earth.
Mm-hmm.
But the Lord went on to say that the church would outshine that darkness.
Right.
And that's what God is doing right now. He's
mm-hmm.
calling forth the church that will shine in hard times,
mm-hmm.
you know, in difficult times,
that's right.
and trust Him to bring them through, Melissa.
That's right.
Hallelujah,
that's right.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
You know, before we go, I'm going to tell you a story that happened last night. Me and Mom decided to go get a little bite to eat after church. We went to Wendy's.
Again.
We didn't go to the same one. We said we're going to go to a different one.
Yes. to a different one.
And you know, we went and we went through drive-thru because they weren't open inside, and we told them what we wanted, and we told them we wanted a fresh, and we kind of told them a little bit about the experience. Mm-hmm. So the lady was very nice, so I really expected my food to be right.
Yes.
I did. We got our food, and we drove off into the parking lot because we usually just sit there and eat. And we get our food out, and it's cold, and I'm just like, I cannot believe this after we just told them what happened, and you know, they assured us that it was going to be hot. So we went back through the drive-thru, and I'm like, you know, I'm not going to have an attitude. I'm going to be nice about it. I'm just going to tell them, you know, what happened. And the girl actually had an attitude a little bit, and I just, you know, this is not hot. You know, we wanted hot, we wanted fresh. And she's like, okay, well, pull up. You know, it's going to take a while to make something new. I said, not a problem. You know, I don't mind waiting. It's going to be fresh. You know, I don't mind.
And Melissa, we ordered a junior bacon cheeseburger, and they put absolutely no bacon.
No bacon.
I love my bacon.
Right. So the whole order was wrong. But you know, yeah. I didn't get upset. I didn't get frustrated.
No,
I'm like,
didn't.
You know what? I'm going to have it. I'm going to let my light shine.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to let the devil use this so I can just get ill and hateful. I'm going to be a Christian and let that light shine.
Yes,
and
thank you,
and
Jesus.
Just be, you know, be nice about it. And I was.
Mm-hmm.
And so we parked. And they came out, I don't know, she said about 5 minutes, but I think it was more like 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And when she brought it out, it was still not right.
It was not right.
It still was not, it wasn't just cooked, put it that way. I think there's the same, maybe the
it
same.
It wasn't hot at all.
No,
it wasn't
none of it
warm.
Was. Yeah.
It wasn't. It was just like, oh my God.
But you know, I'm like, Lord, I really want to get upset. And then I thought about putting this program together, and God said, give thanks and everything. So I'm like, okay, Lord, I'm not going to say nothing. I'm just going to eat this, and I'm going to be thankful.
Yes,
I'm not going to get upset.
That's true.
And you know, a lot of times we put these messages together, and it's not just for you, it's for us.
Yes,
God's
working
on
believe
all
us.
Of
He's
us.
Work, he is, yes. Melissa, that's true.
Yeah, so I want to thank
true.
God for that, because mm-hmm. I give him thanks, because last week, you know, mm-hmm. this week, I was in a bad mood last week, and I didn't have attitude last week, but this week I think I handled even better than last week.
Yeah, you did.
So, you know, I want to give God the praise and the glory for that, because
yes.
He is working in my life.
Melissa, before you go on, Renee asked for what that scripture was that I wrote about, then you will shine among them like the stars. That's found in Philippians 2, 14 and 15. Philippians 2, 14 and 15.
Yes, Renee, we're probably not going to go there again. We went to a different one, but I think I just pretty much wrote that
off.
Oh,
my gosh. I think we're just going to make us hamburgers at home.
That's
from now
true.
On.
Yes.
I mean, really, you know.
But you know what? Thank God that we're able to go down there.
Yes,
you know,
yes.
we're well enough. So I give God all the
yes,
praise and glory
amen.
For
God
it.
God is good.
That's right. He's good.
And then we stopped on the way back at McDonald's and picked up a parcel of hamburger where it would be hot. Yeah. Well, you guys got to remember, we live way out in the country. We live like 15 miles from the valley, down
right.
the valley. And so when you drive down there to get a bite to eat, you want it to be right.
Right. No matter where you go.
Yes, no matter where you go. It's true, but especially when you drive a long distance
That's
to
right.
get it. Yeah.
But we thank God that we're able to do it.
Mm-hmm.
In Colossians 3 and 17, it says, and whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Yes.
Giving thanks to God and the Father by
mm-hmm.
him. Once
mm-hmm.
again, give
mm-hmm.
him thanks. You know, we need to remember we serve a God who's in control. And he sees all.
Yes.
You know, this is, I know that the most thing we should be thankful for is our salvation, but I think this should be the top. That we need to be thankful for, that God is in control.
That's right.
Especially when you look around and you see all
mm-hmm.
the chaos going on in the
mm-hmm.
world, and you see people that don't have no hope. We have hope, because we know who's
hope.
In control
yes,
of everything.
Yes, yes, that's true.
It says in Proverbs 15 and 3, it says, the eyes of the Lord are everywhere, keeping watch on the wicked and the good,
mm-hmm.
which is a good thing. You know, God sees all.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of times we get hurt by people, or people do us wrong, or people lie on us. But you know, we don't need to get back at them. We just pray for them and go on and let God deal with it. Because God
right.
sees
That's
all.
Right.
God's
going right.
to make everything right. Don't worry
mm-hmm.
about it. Don't
mm-hmm.
worry about it. Give mm-hmm. it to God.
Yes.
You know, being thankful or giving thanks is mentioned over 144 times in the Bible.
That's awesome, isn't it?
Yes. Giving thanks must be important to God mm-hmm. if it's mentioned that many times in the Bible.
That's true.
We should be thanking God every day.
Mm-hmm.
Every day. Every
be
breath.
Thankful.
That's right.
Well, you know, Melissa, I mean, I've lived long enough that I've gone through a lot, mm-hmm. you know, from being born up until now. Mm-hmm. I mean, I could tell you that God is a good God.
That's right.
But when I had COVID and I had COVID pneumonia with it and I couldn't breathe, I tell you, I realized how to be thankful
that you
get up every morning and can breathe.
That's right, Mom.
And can breathe. I mean, that verse that we have preached for so many years and talked about, you know, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord.
That's right.
You know, that became real to me when I got where I could not breathe. And Melissa, you were the same way. You still go through bouts of it. But we're thankful that we are alive and that we are well enough to be able to, you know, do what God has called
That's
us
right.
to do. And so we're thankful. We're thankful for God for every breath
That's
that
right.
we get. And for everything that he does for us. And God has been so good to us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think about that too. Many people have not God didn't move the way for them like he has for us.
Mm-hmm.
I believe some of them, God took them home,
mm-hmm.
you know. But I keep telling Melissa and keep telling Apostle, you know, evidently God's not finished with us. You know, he has something great in store for us. And last night when we were talking about stretching our faith, we need to continue to stretch our
That's
faith
right.
and be obedient to God. You know, I hear so many Christians that say, well, I don't know. You know, I just don't know what God wants me to do, or I can't do this or I can't do that. And, you know, that's when we need to get in touch with God.
That's right.
And we need to allow him to stretch our faith to be who he has called us to be.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And be thankful to be able to allow him to mm-hmm. use us for his glory. I'm telling you right now, God has called each one of us to do something for him.
That's right.
And we need to be thankful and be obedient to he has called us to do. Amen.
That's right.
So not only does God want us to give thanks to him but for what he's done and for what he's going to do, but he wants us to be thankful for our brothers and our sisters
mm-hmm.
in the Lord. Not cut them down and talk
right.
about them and be ugly. You know, we see so much of that in the body of Christ, but the Lord wants us to love one another.
That's right.
As a matter of fact, he says in his word, that's how the world will know that we belong to
That's
him
right.
and that we are his disciples, is the love that we have one for another,
mm-hmm.
Melissa. And so we need to love people when they're doing good and also when they're not doing right.
Well, that's the second command, Mom.
Yes,
love
it is.
Love one another.
Uh-huh. It is, Melissa. Love our brothers and
mm-hmm.
sisters. Amen. No matter what they've done,
That's
they're
right.
still our brothers
That's
and sisters.
Right.
You know, when our children were growing up, and of course, you know, I keep telling you that we had 6 children, 3 boys and 3 girls. And, you know, when they would get upset with one another and have their little fights, you know, their dad and I would sit them down and talk to them. And then we would make them hug and kiss one another and tell each other that they loved each other. You know, the church needs to do that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we need to, if we hurt somebody, we need to ask them to forgive
That's
us.
Right.
And then we need to give them a great big hug and tell them that we love them.
That's
and
right.
just move on.
Mm-hmm.
Just go ahead and move on.
That's right.
And our children are still very, very close today.
Mm-hmm.
And all of them are grown, you know, and serve the Lord. Most of them serve the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we instilled that into them,
That's
that
right.
no matter how upset you get, you must forgive
mm-hmm.
and make up and move on, and we should do that in the body of Christ.
That's right.
It says in 2 Thessalonians 1:3, it says, we ought always to thank God for you, brothers and sisters, for your brothers and sisters, and rightly so, because your faith is growing more and more, and the love all of you have for one another is increasing.
Mm-hmm.
And so we need to stretch our, not only stretch our faith, Melissa, but we need to stretch our love. Stretch our love. Be able to love the unlovable.
That's right.
And I'm telling you right now, as God brings in the end time harvest, as he uses his people to bring in the end time harvest,
mm-hmm.
it's going to take love.
That's right.
It's going to take love. There's a lot of people that are not lovable,
mm-hmm.
and they don't look like us or smell like us or act like us, but
mm-hmm.
we need to have love for them, Melissa.
That's right.
We need to have love for them. I remember I saw a few years back how a beggar, in other words, I'll go back and just tell it from the beginning. A church, I guess her pastor had resigned, and they ended up hiring another pastor to come in. And so this pastor decided that he would put this church to the test. And so he dressed up where nobody could recognize him. He looked like a bum. He looked like someone that lived on the street, the homeless man. And he came into church to see how they would treat him. And he was not happy with the way they treated him. And that was a test. And that's what God is doing. He's putting us through a test. He wants to see our heart. He wants to see our heart. He wants to know if we're thankful and if we love one another. You know, Apostle Paul was one who was always giving thanks to God for his brothers and sisters and his spiritual children in the faith.
That's right.
Paul had a prayer and thankful life toward God. Mm-hmm. He was constantly giving God the glory and thanking God for what God had done for him. Mm-hmm. It says in 1 Corinthians 1:4, I always thank my God for you because of his grace given you in Christ Jesus. And so he's thanking God for those, his brothers and sisters and those spiritual ones, his spiritual children that God has given him. Amen. And it also says in Philippians 1:3, I thank my God every time I remember you. Are you like that?
Mm-hmm.
Are you like that? Listen, we need to check our heart.
Mm-hmm.
Do you thank God every time we think of someone?
That's
we thank
right.
thank God for them? We need to.
That's right.
We should have a thankful heart.
Mm-hmm.
And when we think of one of our brothers and sisters in the Lord, whether it's good or bad,
right.
we need to be thankful for them and
That's
love
right.
them and pray for them.
That's, right.
That's one of the things that we need to be doing. We all, like I said earlier, we need one another.
That's right.
We need you. You need us. We need each other. You know, the ministers of the gospel, the fivefold ministry, we need the body of Christ. We need you praying and interceding on our behalf. Amen. You know, the devil is having a field day with leadership. And he wants to take all of us out where we can't do what God's called us to do and glorify God. So we need one another. We need
That's
to
right.
love. I mean love one another with the love of the Lord. Not just say, I love you, but really mean it. You know, I remember our pastor used to say he could tell when someone really loved him or not. He said because when they shook his hand, he could tell if their heart wasn't right because it felt like shaking hands with a cold fish's tail. And I thought about that for so many years. I thought, how in the world did he know that? It was discernment.
Right,
see, that
right.
was when I first got saved. And I didn't know a whole lot.
That's
but
true.
You know what? God wants us to love one another.
That's
and really
right.
mean it. When you tell somebody you'll pray for them, pray for them.
That's right.
Pray for them. Don't just forget about it. Pray for them. They ask you to pray for them. They need prayer.
That's right.
Pray for them. Amen.
That's
Hallelujah.
That your word means something.
Uh-huh. That's right.
God also wants us to be thankful for our enemies.
Yeah.
I know some of us might not want to hear that this morning,
mm-hmm.
but he does. He wants us to love them also.
Yes, yes.
It says in Luke 6:35, but love your enemies, do good to them.
Mm-hmm.
So not only love them, do good
mm-hmm.
to them.
Mm-hmm.
Lend to them without expecting to get anything back.
Yes, yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Then your reward will be great, and you will be children of the Most High, because he is kind to the ungrateful and wicked.
Yes.
You know, God doesn't ask us to do anything that he isn't willing to do.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We need to remember God loved us
yes.
when we were ungrateful.
Ungrateful.
When
That's
we were
right.
wicked. We were wicked. If we weren't saved, we were wicked, whether you want to believe it or not. And that is something we all need to be thankful for.
Yes.
Because he had mercy on us.
Mm-hmm.
He had compassion on us while we were yet sinners.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we need to take the same attitude that God takes. Like you said, Mom, love the unlovable.
Yes.
You know, love them right into God, right into Christ. That's
yes.
what it's going to take to
That's
win the
true.
Lost. It's not going to be you're going to hell, you're going to hell.
Yes.
It's going to be love, love, love.
Yes, yes.
And I'm not saying there's not the hell side to it. There is, but you know what? That don't work usually.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Christina. We're praying for you and your family. Hope they're feeling better. That's so true, Melissa. I remember when I worked for the state of Arizona, we had a lady in our department. She was very mean. I mean, she was just mean.
Mm-hmm.
And as a woman of God, God gave me favor with the boss over our department. God really gave me favor with her. And because God gave me favor with her, this girl became very jealous of me. And she was just mean. I mean, just, have you ever seen anybody that was just mean?
Yes.
I mean, you try to do everything that you could, but whatever you did was wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord spoke to me one day, and the Lord said, start praying for Angela. Mm-hmm. Pray for her. Show her love and pray for her. And you know, I did. I started praying for her, and I would be nice to her. I would anything that I could do to help her. She was a secretary in our department. Anything that I could do to help her, I would. And I would bring her little things and give them to her, and just really showed her a lot of love. And we were having a conference, and I just really felt like the Lord wanted me to invite Angela to the conference. And I was thinking in myself, mm-hmm. it won't do any good, but you know, I'm going to go ahead and invite her. And so I walked over to her desk and I told her, I said, Angela, I want to invite you to a conference. We have mm-hmm. a man of God that's coming in. He's a prophet. And I really feel like that, you know, God wants you to go. And she said, really? She said, yes, I want to come. And you know, she came and wow. she gave her heart to the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I could have been mean back to her
right.
and never won her to the Lord, Melissa.
That's right.
And I felt like it. You know,
right.
have you ever just felt like
yeah.
stop just slapping the meanness out of people? You know, we do because we're all human. You know,
mm-hmm.
we just want to, you know, just want to take that hand and slap them and tell God it was an accident. But God knows, doesn't he?
That's right.
But you know what? We need to be good to people.
Mm-hmm.
Treat them nice,
that's
you
right.
know, love them. And that's what it takes to win people to the Lord.
That's right. Mom, I just want to tell you too,
mm-hmm.
a little story before we go on to the next one.
Okay.
I had a similar situation before I moved out here. I went back to work, and I went to work at a bank. And usually when I work places, I usually get favor with the bosses too, because I believe because I'm a hard worker,
mm-hmm.
I'm honest, and
mm-hmm.
I do what they ask me to do. And my boss, she was just really, same thing, mean. It's almost
yes,
like she's picking
mean,
on me. And I'm like, and I don't understand what's going on.
Yes.
And I remember I was talking to my dad, I didn't live here. And he's like, well, Melissa, you know, you don't have to put up with that. Because I was getting
yeah.
ready to quit. I'm like, I can't take this.
Right,
I'm going through a divorce
right,
and it's just too much.
Yes.
And, you know, I started praying about it. And so one day I went to work and I'm like, you know, can I talk to you? I'm like, can we talk private? And we went into a room and I'm like, you know, I just feel like there's something going on with you. And it seems like you're always like just mean to me. And I go, did I do anything to hurt you? Did I do anything? You know, I'm sorry. Did I do anything to you?
Mm-hmm.
And because I humbled myself,
mm-hmm.
she started breaking down. And she's like, no, her husband was going through cancer. And she, I guess she said, maybe I'm taking it out on you. And, you know, we talked and we cleared the air. But, you know, I didn't, because I humbled myself and asked her to forgive me, even though I knew I didn't do anything.
Mm-hmm.
But
mm-hmm.
God used that to open the door for me to be able to talk to her about God,
yes.
to witness to her.
Mm-hmm.
And so, like you said, Mom, if we just have a kind heart, a lot of times people are going through things too.
They are.
And sometimes you're like, you know, well, there's still no reason for you to be ugly towards me.
Yes.
But we have the answer. We
mm-hmm.
have the hope.
Mm-hmm.
We have what they're looking for.
We do.
You know,
and
so,
they want it.
That's right.
They don't really know what they want, but they
right.
want what we have.
That's right.
Know? That's right, Brother David. Walk the walk. That's true. We have to walk the walk. Amen?
That's right.
You know, sometimes we talk big, but when it comes down to walking the walk,
mm-hmm.
I think some Christians have missed that.
Mm-hmm.
But we do need to walk the walk all the time.
Right.
All the time. That's true.
Right.
So, Melissa, were you finished?
I was finished,
okay.
Yes.
King David knew what it was to be thankful to the Lord.
That's right.
You can read all about David thanking the Lord in the book of Psalms. I love the book of Psalms.
Yes.
You know, it's really encouraging. Even when his enemies had him trapped, or when the enemy captured the women and the wives, remember that?
Mm-hmm.
His own men were getting ready to turn against him. Well, they did
That's
turn
right.
against
That's
him.
Right.
They were going to stone David.
And kill him.
And, you know, yes, and David inquired of the Lord.
That's right.
I mean, you know, the enemy had come in and burned down their city or their
mm-hmm.
town and took everything away from them, even their wives and their children.
Mm-hmm.
And David inquired of the Lord, and the Lord told him what to do. The Lord told him, yes, you go and you will recover all.
That's right.
And I have a word for somebody this morning that's listening. You know, God says you're going to recover all. God says you are going to recover all. Everything that the enemy has stolen from you, God says you will recover all. You will. I just keep hearing the Lord say that. So just take that to heart and move as God speaks to your heart, and you will recover all that the enemy has stolen from you. So David knew who to put his trust in.
Right.
And I want to ask you this morning, who are you trusting?
Mm-hmm.
Who are you trusting? You know, are you trusting your husband or your wife or your boss or your pastor or your best friend? Or are you putting your trust in the Lord?
That's right.
Are you putting your trust in the Lord? Yes, I trust all of my family and my friends and those that God has brought in my life.
Mm-hmm.
But my greatest faith and trust is in the Lord Jesus
That's
Christ.
Right.
God will never let us down. Now, mm-hmm. man will let us down, but God never will. And
That's
we ought
right.
to always give him the praise, Melissa.
That's right.
So David had a heart after God.
Mm-hmm.
You know, heart after God. Not because all the battles that he won or the wealth that he accumulated, but because King David knew how to praise and give thanks to God. He was a worshiper.
That's right.
A worshiper. We need to learn to worship
mm-hmm.
God when times are good
mm-hmm.
and also when times are bad.
That's
I've heard
right.
many testimonies about people going through some really hard times with sickness or disease or their children, you know, rebelling or
mm-hmm.
the husband walking off and leaving them or their wife, you know, whatever it is, and they praise God through it.
That's right.
They praise God through it. We have one of our spiritual daughters, Teresa, she's a wonderful, wonderful woman of God, and she went through some devastating things several years ago. And you know what? She praised her way through, Melissa.
That's right.
She served God. She
mm-hmm.
refused to be ugly. She refused to say anything about her husband or the church or anything, you know. And she just kept praising God
mm-hmm.
and staying focused. In other words, she took the high road.
That's right.
She took the high road.
That's
and,
right.
you know, God has blessed her for it.
Mm-hmm.
We're so proud of her. So David knew the one thing that God desires above all else with a heart that would worship and praise him, not from his lips, but from his heart.
That's
See, God
right.
knows our heart.
Mm-hmm.
God knows our heart. God knows
mm-hmm.
if we're giving him lip service
That's right.
or heart service.
That's right.
He knows that.
That's right.
He really does. He's
That's
an
right.
all-knowing God.
That's right.
And so he wants us to worship and praise him and give him thanks from the heart. Appreciate God.
Mm-hmm.
Love God. Honor
oh, yes.
God. Yes.
yes.
And you know, he will reward us for
mm-hmm.
our faithfulness.
Yes.
He really will. That's not the reason that we do it,
mm-hmm.
but he will reward us for our faithfulness
mm-hmm.
to him. And we need to learn to give God all the glory.
That's right.
You know, I hear people sometimes, I this, I that, I. We need to give the glory to God.
Mm-hmm.
It's about God. You know, any good thing
mm-hmm.
that I do, I give that glory
That's
to God.
Right.
I was sharing last night, I just finished my fifth book, and I give God the glory
That's
for that
right.
book. You know, at the very last chapter, God began to speak to me to change the title of the book. And I'm saying, oh, Lord, no, not that. and the Lord began to speak to my heart, and I said, okay, God, I'll do it.
Right.
And so, you know, God is an awesome God.
Yes.
He loves you and me, and
That's
he
right.
wants our, you know, he wants good things for us, but we have to trust him and make sure that we give him all the glory, Melissa.
That's right.
Give him all the glory.
That's right. I always think about, especially if I'm going through things, I think about, too, the things he's done for me.
Mm-hmm.
But I read the Bible because that's very encouraging, too, the things that
it
people
is.
Have gone through,
it
David
is.
And everything. But, you know, it's also, too, encouraging when you know other things that happen in your life. Like, I always think about
mm-hmm.
Apostle when he talks about how we're traveling through our younger years. And how the truck wouldn't work.
We were evangelizing. Mm-hmm.
And the truck broke down, and we were stuck on the side of the road. And he's walking up and down asking God, what's he going to do? And God said, why don't you worship me?
Mm-hmm.
Worship
praise
is,
me.
That's right, why don't you praise me?
Uh-huh.
And that's the most powerful thing is when you praise God in the middle of the storm. That touches the heart of God.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, when it's from your heart, you're like, okay, Lord, no matter what, I'm going to praise you. You're
yes.
still good.
Yes, that's
if
good.
If nothing happens today, if you don't do one other thing for me, I'm still going to praise you.
That's right.
You're still God, and you're still the Savior of my soul.
Mm-hmm.
That touches the heart of God.
Yes.
And I think you said that before, Prophetess. You said, you know, if God never does anything for me, he's done enough.
Yes, yes, I'm telling you.
That's
I could
right.
write many, many
mm-hmm.
books. And maybe I will be able to do that before the Lord comes,
mm-hmm.
is just to give my testimony about all that God has
mm-hmm.
done in my life and
That's
my
right.
husband's life
mm-hmm.
and our children. I mean, it's just been an awesome walk with the Lord, and we've seen God perform one miracle after
That's
the
right.
other. One miracle
mm-hmm.
after the other. Pastor Edward is a miracle.
That's right.
You know, when he was born, I'm telling you, it looked like he was going to die. Mm-hmm. It really did. It, you know, and the doctor told my husband, I can save either one of them, either your wife or your child. And my husband says, I refuse to believe that. And we weren't serving the Lord at that time. And he made his way down to the chapel, and he cried out to God like David does.
That's right.
And, you know, he told the Lord, he just laid it flat out. He said, God, if you'll save my wife and my baby, I will serve you. Mm-hmm. I will do whatever you ask me to do.
That's
because
right.
at that time, my husband was running from the Lord.
That's right.
He really didn't want to be a preacher. You know, and I don't think any of us really do. I wonder about people that want to be a preacher.
Yeah.
But anyway, you know, he promised God, if you'll just save my wife and my child, you know, I will serve you.
Mm-hmm.
I will go wherever you tell me to.
That's
and people
right.
will say sometimes, you know, it just looks crazy about how you guys have gone here and there and everywhere. And you said God told you to go. But my husband made God a promise
mm-hmm.
that if he would do what he asked him to do, he would do whatever he asked him to do.
That's right.
And Melissa, that's what we've done. We've
that's
tried
right.
to
oh,
do
yes.
that the best of our heart. You
mm-hmm.
kids know that.
Oh, yes.
I know sometimes you wondered about mom and dad. You know, I don't know about this, man. This is way out. But you know what?
Right.
A lot of stuff that God tells us to do is way out.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we have to stretch our faith.
That's right.
You don't sell everything you got
oh, yeah.
and you have six little kids and you load up them in a motor home. And take off to go
mm-hmm.
to the Indian reservations
that's
to
right.
to minister the word of God. You know, I mean, six small children. It was God. We
right.
obeyed the Lord.
Right.
You kids learned more through that than I think you did the whole years that you went to school.
Oh yeah, oh,
you know,
definitely.
I mean, there was just one thing after another
mm-hmm.
that you learned that you have talked about now.
Mm-hmm.
That you're older, you think back about how
mm-hmm.
what God did.
That's
there was
right.
one time, I just want to share this with you. There was two other families that were traveling with us. There were 16 of us on our team, and most of them was children. And we ate everything that we had. We fed everything. We had enough for one meal. And we cooked that, the ladies and I cooked that, and we gave that to our children, and we fasted and prayed. And we said, God, we don't know, you know, what we're going to do, but you
mm-hmm.
have to move on our behalf. And we were in New Mexico at the Navajo Reservation. We had the motorhome parked there, and all of us were just, you know, believing God.
Mm-hmm.
And we believed in God. And that afternoon, there's a woman from town came. And she said, you know, the Lord, she owned a restaurant. She said, you know, the
mm-hmm.
Lord spoke to me to bring you guys some food. She said, and so I have a bunch of food out here. And she said, and some soda and some different things for you guys. And she did. And, you know, my husband and the guys began to take it out of her van and bring it in. And we had food to eat until God began to move and provide in another way for us. But I'm telling you right
mm-hmm.
now, if you are obedient to God, God will take care of you.
That's right.
And we began to praise the Lord
That's
and
right.
thank the Lord. And our children they knew that.
That's right.
And they brought stuff for the kids,
mm-hmm.
you know. And one of the sisters that were with us, she liked Diet Pepsi.
Mm-hmm.
And potato chips. That was her, you know, that was her thing. And you go, you guys might laugh, but you all have something you like too. Amen?
Amen.
And you know, that lady brought a whole case of Diet Pepsi and a whole thing of bags of potato chips.
That's right.
And she just started crying, you
mm-hmm.
know, I mean, because she really believed that God did
That's
that
right.
for her.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
You know, and
mm-hmm.
God does do things like that. He
just
makes
for
himself
you.
Real
That's right.
just for you.
Mm-hmm.
And we just give him the glory for it because we didn't ask anybody to give us
mm-hmm.
anything, Melissa.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we don't
you
beg for
God,
money.
You asked God.
You know, we did.
That's
we
right.
went to God.
Mm-hmm.
We don't beg for money
That's
and we
right.
don't say, oh, poor me, I don't know what we're going to have to do. But we moved in faith
That's
and
right.
God moved on our behalf.
That's right. And you know, and if she wasn't obedient, God would have used somebody else. And if they weren't obedient, God would have used himself.
He would have.
He came
yes.
down himself. He would have sent an angel.
Yes.
So God will always come through for
yes,
you.
Yes, yes. He is an awesome
you.
God.
That's right.
Prophet for day. He
right there
is
something
awesome.
To be thankful for just right there.
Yes.
You know,
mm-hmm.
you know he's
mm-hmm.
a good God.
Yes, we love him. We love him.
That's right. In Philippians 4 and 6, it says, do not be anxious about anything,
mm-hmm.
but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving,
yes,
present
yes.
your request to God. So when we pray and ask God for whatever we have need of,
mm-hmm.
we must not forget to thank him for
yes,
all that he has
forget
done.
To thank him. That's
you
right.
know, thank him for what he's done,
mm-hmm.
but also thank him for what he's going to do.
Yes.
And that's
yes.
stretching your faith again, mm-hmm. Prophetess.
You know, I just want to say this now. I just really feel like I need to say this. You know, we shared last night how we stretched our faith for this home.
Mm-hmm.
Melissa
oh, yes.
and myself and my husband, we stretched our faith and we moved as God began to speak
mm-hmm.
to us. And right now we're praying and asking God to give us a building.
Mm-hmm.
And we're looking and we're have our ears open and our eyes
mm-hmm.
open and we're waiting in the spirit for God
That's
to
right.
move. And you know, in the natural, Brother David, and you know, you've been with us long enough that you know, in the natural, it looks impossible.
Mm-hmm.
It does. It looks impossible.
That's right.
It looks like we need to go somewhere else where the buildings are cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm talking to you right now. We live in Scottsdale, Arizona. And it's one of the richest places there is, I think, in this state. What I say is people have money here.
Mm-hmm.
And so the price of living is very high. Buildings are very high.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? We're stretching our faith.
That's right.
We're stretching our faith, Melissa. We know that God has a place just for
He's
us.
He's called us here.
The Soaring Eagle Ministries
mm-hmm.
International. We know that. You know, look at it this way. God has put together a team.
Mm-hmm.
God has brought our children in to help
That's
us.
Right.
You know, God has brought others in to help us.
Mm-hmm.
So God knows that we're going to need a meeting place.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you, Melissa, I feel the power
That's
of
right.
God moving right
That's
now.
Right.
But you know what? We're stretching our faith.
Mm-hmm.
We're believing God for the impossible because it looks impossible because
yes.
we have just a small group of people.
Mm-hmm.
But listen to me, there's nothing impossible
That's
with
right.
God. And I'm not only talking to us here at Soaring Eagle Ministries, but I'm talking to those that are listening this morning. There's nothing impossible with God. So stop looking at the circumstances and look to Him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's there's nothing too big for Him. Too big for Him. You know, He wants to move for you. And we know that in His timing, we will have that building that He has just for Soaring Eagle Ministries.
That's right.
And we're excited about it, don't we, Melissa?
That's right.
We are excited about it.
Oh, I know. When I listen to worship music in the car, it's
mm-hmm.
like, man, I can't wait to get back to church. I mean, I worship God here, but it's nothing like the presence with other people.
No, we love our
and,
people.
And we worship the Lord for a few moments here in
mm-hmm.
before the program,
mm-hmm.
and I could feel the presence of God. But it's so nice to just soak in the presence with other people.
Yes,
and
yes.
just lift up His name.
Mm-hmm.
And like you said, Prophetess, we're a small group, but you know what? Jesus had a small group. He had 12 men that turned the world upside down.
That's right.
God don't need 100 people, 1,000 people,
oh,
a million
hallelujah.
People. He only needs a willing heart. The Bible says a little with God is much.
That's true, Melissa. You
so,
preach it, girl.
You know,
uh-huh.
I believe it's coming too. We're standing on His word. He's
mm-hmm.
given us dreams.
Yes.
And I don't believe God's doing this all for nothing.
No.
I don't believe
no,
it.
No.
But we have to believe and we have to have faith in which we are. We're standing on His word. We're stretching our faith. And it's going to happen. And we know what we're going to say. We're going to say this is the God thing.
Yes.
This only happened
yes.
because God was in control.
Uh-huh.
Where nobody's going to get the glory and the praise but our God. Just like this house,
mm-hmm.
I still thank God for this house. I look around like, Lord, thank you. This is a beautiful house. And,
mm-hmm.
you know, if it's gone tomorrow, it's gone tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'm not living
for God. If God got finished with us here
right.
and says to move somewhere else, we'd do it.
Right. But you still give thanks and praise to God for everything you have.
Mm-hmm.
Everything.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. Save the last for the best.
What is Brother David saying there before that?
Brother David is saying, I notice that and feel spiritually this must be priority from Father God, that we must stretch our faith because
mm-hmm.
what was said last night was exact dovetail message off of what Apostle preached earlier this year about stretching our faith.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right. That's right,
That's
Brother
right.
David. Hallelujah.
That's right.
And you know, Brother David is one of the ones that God has
mm-hmm.
brought in to help us.
That's right.
Melissa.
He's going to be teaching. That's
yes,
right.
he's going to be teaching on
That's
staff.
Right.
I'm telling you,
That's right.
I feel so excited
mm-hmm.
I could jump up
That's
and
right.
dance. And I mean,
let's go, Lord. Let's go do it now. But we have to wait on
yes.
Him.
Yes, and that's what prophets do.
That's
when
right.
prophets get the mind of God, they want to go now and do it. But apostles, you know, God. Wired them different,
mm-hmm.
and so they have to wait till the right timing. And sometimes prophets don't understand that.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, God is he's awesome. He's just awesome. There's nothing too hard for God. And I know that just like we're sitting here in our home, there will come a day that we will be in our building. And we will have our own studio. God has spoke that too, Melissa, that we would have our own studio. And you know, not only that, God is going to bring other people in.
That's right.
You know, I one dream I had that God was speaking to people's hearts to move here and help us to bring in this end time harvest. And I believe that. I believe it. I believe it. The most important thing that we can do anytime, but surely right now, is be obedient to God.
That's right.
Be obedient to God. Hey, there's nothing too hard for Him.
That's right.
And He will not call us to do something that's impossible.
That's right. That's right, Mom.
You know.
That's right. You know, let us not get caught up and the things that we need that we forget to thank Him.
Yes, yes, yes.
It says in Ephesians 5 and 20, always give thanks to God the Father for everything.
Yes.
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
You know, God wants us to live a life of thanksgiving in the good times and in the bad times.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's easy to thank God when everything is going right. But if we live a life of thanksgiving, it won't be difficult. If that's something that we're doing all the time, if we let it become a habit, it won't be difficult to praise God during the storm, because that's something we're just used to doing.
Mm-hmm.
So let it become a habit that we wake up, thanksgiving is on our lips, that we thank Him. Hey Lord, thank you Lord that my eyes are open today.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you Lord that you gave me another day to live for you.
Yes.
You know, as we're going to sleep, thank God that He gave you another day.
That's right.
You know?
And it's just not, Thanksgiving is not just for one day.
No, it's every day.
You know, we do know that, you know, our country has set aside a day that we call Thanksgiving, and we're thankful for that.
That's right.
But we need to thank God every day.
That's right.
And I do have another praise report. If anybody has a praise report or a prayer request, I would ask you to go ahead and put it in what we can pray before we go off. But Pastor Britt, those of you that know our granddaughter, Pastor Britt, she was in a car accident about a month ago, Melissa.
I don't think so.
And we thank God that she was not hurt, but she totaled her car. And that's a long story in itself right there. But God moved by His Spirit for her to be able to get a new car. The Lord spoke to me and said that she would get a new car. And she said, Grandma, I don't think it's totaled. They told me they could fix it. But you know, when God speaks, you have to listen to what God is saying and then proceed. And so we went, Wendy was here, and we all went over with her and to look at more cars. And she wanted another Toyota. And was it Toyota? I think it was. Anyway, they had nothing on the lot, nothing. I mean, it's slim pickings, as they say, with cars right now, or just about anything right now. And they said to Britt, they said, well, we don't have anything on the lot, but we can order you a new car. A new car, just like the one you have, except the one you had was a 2018, and the one that we'll order will be a 2022.
Wow.
And she just sort of looked at me and her grandpa and her mom, and you were with us, weren't you, Melissa?
No,
you went with us.
No,
anyhow, she said, okay, and so they did all the paperwork and everything, and they had her to pick out the color she wanted and everything. And so she was going to, you know, take the insurance money that she got that was overpaying off the old car and pay down on her new car. But she had problems with getting it. Well, they called her this week and told her car had been shipped here, a brand new car, no one's ever driven it, and that she could come in and get it. And but her check, insurance check, was being held up. And we began to pray and pray and decree that God was going to release that check in time, because she wanted to go tomorrow and pick up her car. She called me from work last night, or messaged me from work last night, and said, Grandma, I got my check. I got my check. So Friday, we're going to go with her to pick up her car, and we're going to celebrate with her. And listen to this, people. I mean, just listen to what God did. You know, she got enough out of her old car to make a down payment of $10,000 on her new car. And she will only owe as much on this new car as she already owed on her old car. And so her payments will be the same. I mean, God is something else. A brand new car, and for the same price, and for this, I mean, only God can do
that's right,
Melissa.
That's right.
Especially the way everything is right now.
Right.
You know, I mean, they're trying to, you know, as they say, a lot of companies are trying to stiff us. Is that what they call it?
Jack the price.
Yeah,
up.
Jack the prices up. And, but anyway, when God speaks, God moves
that's right.
We'll believe Him for it.
That's right.
We just want to give God the glory. We don't thank God. Thank God, because Melissa, I mean, Brittany needs a car.
That's right.
She's a respiratory respiratory therapist. She has to have a car to go back
that's
and
right.
forth to work. And so I'm telling you right now what God meant, what the devil meant for evil, God turned it around for her good and for His glory.
That's right. And God's in control. That's
yes.
right. Yes. Thank God's
yes.
in control. Renee has a praise report. Avery is continuing to improve each day. Also, Larry will be discharged from hospital next week.
Praise
he
God.
Has been reading the Word. The Lord said He has given him a second chance. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow,
that's wonderful.
Something else.
That
is wonderful.
Wonderful.
Yes, thank
yes.
you, Jesus, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
You know, I do want us to continue to pray for Sister Carol. I mentioned last night she is our spiritual daughter in the Lord, but she is in the hospital, and she needs God to move. In many different areas of her life. You know, we just have such a burden for her. And we're asking you guys to continue to pray with us. I mean, her future don't look good.
No.
And I'm not talking about that she's going to die or anything like that. But Carol has some serious problems, and only God can move in them, Melissa.
That's right.
And so we're asking you people that are listening, our dear brothers and sisters, to remember Carol. Yes. And so we're asking you to help us.
That's right.
Reach God on her behalf. What is the process saying?
The program is reaching those that have an ear to hear.
Yes,
that's
amen.
Right.
God
right.
is so good. God is so good. But her name is Carol Trishner. And she's a sweet, lovely person, but right now she needs the help of the body of Christ.
That's right.
And if God don't move, I don't really know what she's going to do, and I'm going to leave it there. And Brother David, you know, she's a very good friend of yours. You used to ride with her coming to church. And so we ask you to pray for Carol. And Melissa, you want to go ahead and pray for again before we go
yes.
off? Like I said, if anybody else has a prayer request, please post it right now, because we're getting to go off. We're getting ready to go off.
Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you that we're here this morning, Lord. Lord, we come before you on behalf of Sister Carol again, Lord. We're asking you, Lord, to move on her behalf, Lord. Lord, you know all the things that are going on with
yes,
her. You know all the
Jesus.
Issues,
yes,
all
Lord.
The roadblocks, all the things that are coming up against her, Lord.
Yes.
We ask you, Lord, to work it out for her good. You, Lord, we don't even know all the things that she's going through.
No,
but Lord,
we
you know
Lord.
What's going on with Sister Carol,
that's right.
Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, you've made her, and Lord, you can come to her rescue, Lord. We ask
yes.
you to just put the right people in her path that need to help her to get to where she needs to go, Father
yes.
God.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Lord, and help her to get well, Lord. Lord, speak to her spirit, man, Lord, and just be with her to give her comfort
yes,
during this crucial
yes,
time,
Jesus.
Father God. And we bind all the forces of hell that try to come against Sister Carol. You cannot
yes,
have her. You
Jesus.
Cannot stop her. And we put a hedge around Sister Carol.
Yes, Lord.
Put your angels around her, Lord, that nothing bad can happen to her, Father God. And Lord, we just ask this in your precious name this morning. Thank
amen,
you, Jesus.
Amen,
thank
amen,
you,
amen,
thank
amen.
You,
well, okay. We're going to go ahead and go mm-hmm. off, Melissa. And we just ask you to just continue to pray for us as we pray for you.
That's right.
We won't be on next Thursday. It's
no.
Thanksgiving Day, and I know we'll all be with our families.
That's
We're
right.
just so excited. Melissa, this is the first time our family has gotten together in a long time for Thanksgiving. And so we're thankful for that,
That's
how
right.
God has moved. All of us has got our shots, and so we should be safe. Amen.
Amen.
We're believing God. Yes, Lord.
Pray for God's continued favor and blessing. Yes.
Yes,
yes.
Amen. Thank
That's
you,
right.
Lord. That's
Thank
right,
you,
Brother
Jesus.
David. Amen.
Thank you,
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. And we all need the Lord, don't we? Melissa,
right.
you want to go ahead and pray before we go
That's
off?
Right. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, that we're here today. We thank you that
yes.
you woke us up this morning.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you that you woke all these people up on Facebook, Lord,
yes,
on Twitter
Jesus.
And YouTube, Lord. We ask you, Lord, to keep your hand upon your people.
Yes.
Lord, to put that hedge of protection around
Move
them, Lord
by
Jesus.
Your spirit, Lord.
Lord, bless them, their comings and their going, Lord. Give them favor, Father
Hallelujah,
God.
Hallelujah.
Let us stretch our faith, Lord, to believe you for the impossible, Lord.
Yes.
Let us be thankful at everything that we do, everything that we see, Lord. Let us have that heart after you, Father God. We ask you, Lord, just keep your hand upon your people until we see them next week.
Yes.
And this we ask in
yes.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
So either Pastor Edward or Apostle will be here on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know for sure if we'll be here Wednesday night. We will let you know. Just, you know, stay tuned on Facebook.
That's right.
And we just, you know, if we don't talk to you again, we just say we hope you have a happy Thanksgiving.
Yes,
enjoy
right.
it with your family and loved ones. And continue to show the love of Christ.
That's
Amen.
Right. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
God bless you. We love you guys.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.